just about 5 miles wide, but 1.4 times more massive than the Sun. This is the neutron star, the imploded core of a massive star created by a supernova explosion. When a massive star dies in a supernova, the star's iron core remains. While the core packs as much mass as about two suns, its size shrinks to a sphere about the size of Manhattan. If you brought a sugar cube of neutron star matter to Earth, it would weigh as much as all of humanity. These stellar remnants are some of the most enigmatic and densest objects in the universe. You've probably heard that everything in the universe is made of atoms, right? Well, not neutron stars. The gravitational pull of these stars is so great that even atoms get crushed. The repulsive force between the electrons and protons isn't enough to keep them separated. Thus, gravity crashes them into one another to form neutrons. So, the tiny star is made entirely of neutrons. Here's a slice of a neutron star. The solid outer crust and superfluid inner core may be responsible for pulsar glitches, which are sudden increases in the spin frequency of an otherwise steadily spinning down neutron star. The crust basically cracks or slips on the superfluid neutrons to create star quakes. Some neutron stars beam radiation from their poles. As they spin, the beams sometimes face toward us. We call this a pulsar star. Neutron stars have a thin atmosphere made primarily of hydrogen and helium. The deeper you go inside a neutron star, the stranger it gets. The gravity of a neutron star is so strong that all of the particles in a neutron star are pulled together as tightly as possible, thus resulting in a solid, super smooth spherical surface, just a centimeter or two thick. Computer models indicate that the surface is composed of ordinary atomic nuclei and a sea of free-roaming electrons. Scientists think that the nuclei at the surface are iron due to iron's high binding energy per nucleon. No one is quite sure what the internal structure of a neutron star is, but the current idea is that the star possesses a thin crust of iron, maybe about a mile thick. The area under that is largely composed of neutrons, taking various forms the further down they are. Over millions of years, the latent heat of a neutron star gradually cools from an initial 600,000 Kelvin, 1 million degrees Fahrenheit, or 600,000 degrees Celsius, eventually ending its life as the cold, dead remnant of a once fabulously glowing star. Studying neutron stars is so important for everybody, from X-ray to radio astronomers. These dense objects can help us better understand how neutrons and protons interact and how quantum chromodynamics work. Quantum chromodynamics is the theory of the strong interaction between quarks mediated by gluons. Also, neutron stars are some of the few objects in the universe where we can study matter, which is both dense and cold. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.